announcing the arrival of Yang Berhormat Dato Sri Mohamed Khaled bin Nordin, Minister of Higher Education, and Yang Amat Mulia Tuanku Zain Al-Abidin Ibni Tuanku Muhriz, Pro-Chancellor of UCSI University, accompanied by senior officials from Ministry of Higher Education, Malaysian Qualification Agency, and UCSI University. Please remain standing for the national anthem. Be seated. Good morning and Salam Malaysia Madani to Yang Berhormat Datuk Sri Mohamed Khaled bin Nordin, Minister of Higher Education, Yang Amat Mulia Tuanku Zain Al-Abidin Ibni Tuanku Muhriz, Pro Chancellor of UCSI University, Yang Berbahagia Profesor Datuk Dr. Husaini bin Omar, Director General of the Department of Higher Education of Malaysia, Ministry of Higher Education, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Mohamed Khairul Adib Abdul Rahman, Chairman, Malaysia Qualifications Agency Council, Yang Berbahagia Profesor Datuk Dr. Mohamed Shatar bin Sabran, Chief Executive Officer, Malaysian Qualifications Agency, Yang Berbahagia Datuk Peter Ng, UCSI Group Founder and Executive Chairman, Yang Berbahagia Profesor Datuk Insinyur Teknologis Dr. Siti Hamisah binti Tapse, Vice Chancellor of UCSI University and Chief Executive Officer of UCSI Group, Ms. Rehana Parvin, First Secretary of Foreign Affairs, Bangladesh High Commission, Mr. Ariful Bari Majunda, Managing Director of Insight Institute of Learning Bangladesh, Mr. Chan Jol Jim, Pro Vice Chancellor Designate UCSI University Bangladesh Campus, Datuk Dr. Haji Muhammad Karim bin Haji Abdullah Omar, University Council Member, UCSI University, Tan Sri Datuk Sri Dr. Saleh bin Muhammad Nur, University Council Member, UCSI University, Dr. Rosli Mailam, University Council Member, UCSI University, Government Officials of the Ministry of Higher Education, Pro Vice Chancellors, Deputy Vice Chancellors, Senate members, professors, staff of UCSI University, senior management and staff of Insight Institute of Learning Bangladesh, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Datin, Excellencies, members of the media, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Parveen Gil Chansawat from Center for Languages, UCSI University. It is indeed an honor to be the master of ceremony for the soft launch of UCSI University Bangladesh campus. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, today marks a significant milestone for UCSI University as we are about to officially announce the soft launch of our first international campus in Bangladesh. Malaysia has been a hub for international students to pursue their tertiary education for more than three decades. Tens of thousands of international students have been trained by UCSI on the Malaysian soil since then, and today it remains as a choice of students from more than 110 countries. Today's event marks a significant journey that UCSI is taking in its mission to educate and provide opportunities to deserving students in the global stage. By setting up the branch in Bangladesh, many more deserving students can have better access to quality education. In order to commemorate this special occasion, I would like to welcome the Vice Chancellor of UCSI University and Chief Executive Officer of UCSI Group, Yang Berbahagia Professor Dato Insinyur Technologies, Dr. Siti Hamisah Bitin Tapsi, to deliver her speech. Welcome on stage, Yang Berbahagia Dato.
Thank you, Ms. Parveen. Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri Mohamed Khaled bin Nordin, Minister of Higher Education Malaysia. Yang Amat Mulia Tunku Zain Al-Abidin Ibni Tuanku Mohris, Pro-Chancellor of UCSI University. Yang Bahagia Professor Datuk Dr. Husaini bin Omar, Director General of Department of Higher Education. Yang Bahagia Tan Sri Muhammad Khairul Adib bin Abdul Rahman, Chairman of the Malaysian Qualification Agency. Yang Bahagia Profesor Datuk Muhammad Sata bin Sabran, CEO of Malaysian Qualification Agency, ramai my ex-bosses on the same table. Yang Bahagia Datuk Pira Eng, UCSI Group Founder and Executive Chairman, and Board Members. Yang Bahagia Profesor Miss Revana Parveen, First Secretary, Foreign Affairs, Bangladesh High Commissioner, Malaysia. Mr. Ariful Bari Majenda, Managing Director, Insight Institute of Learning, Bangladesh. Government officials of the Ministry of Higher Education, Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Senior Management, and the staff of Insight Institute of Learning and UCSI Group. Yang Bahagia Tan Sri Tan Sri, Datuk-Datuk, Datin-Datin, Tuan-Tuan dan Puan-Puan, Excellencies, Distinguished Guests. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. A very good morning and salam sejahtera. Please allow me to wish all of you selamat datang and welcome to UCSI University. On behalf of UCSI Group and UCSI University, I would like to welcome Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri Muhammad Khaled bin Nordin, the Minister of Higher Education, to the soft launch of UCSI University Bangladesh. Thank you for making time for us despite your busy schedule, sir. I would also like to welcome the representative from the Government of Bangladesh and our valued partners from Insight Institute of Learning Bangladesh. Thank you for coming all the way from Dhaka. Ladies and gentlemen, the first step that led to UCSI's first international branch campus in Bangladesh began in 2019. After 2 years of assessment, analysis, due diligence and negotiations during the pandemic, an MOA was signed with our partner from Bangladesh, Insight Institute of Learning, in May 2021. The main objective of the collaboration was to uphold the shared goal of providing access to quality education, student experience, improving graduates' outcomes, and the life chances of thousands of global citizens. Therefore, we are genuinely pleased and honored that the proposed establishment of UCSI's Bangladesh campus was granted by the Honorable Prime Minister of Bangladesh and approved by the Ministry of Education Bangladesh in 2022. This milestone would not be possible without the support and assistance of so many people and governing authorities, namely the Department of Higher Education Malaysia under the leadership of Professor Dato Husaini bin Omar, who has been continuously communicated with relevant agencies in Bangladesh, the respective chairman of both institutions, Dato Peter Ng, chairman of UCSI University Council, Mr. Molam Wahezuzaman, chairman of Insight Institute of Learning, His Excellency Muhammad Golam Sarwar, the High Commissioner of the People's Republic of Bangladesh to Malaysia, Professor Datuk Dr. Muhammad Sattar bin Sabran and Malaysian Qualification Agency, who has been facilitating in offering UCSI programs abroad, His Excellency Haznah Muhammad Hashim, High Commissioner of Malaysia in Dhaka, Mr. Ahmad Darul Akmal from the Education Malaysia office in Dubai, and of course, the two gentlemen, the key person for this program and initiative is Mr. Ariful Bahri from Insight Institute of Learning and Mr. Who is from UCSI Global Engagement Office. Distinguished guests, please give them a big round of applause. I may not be able to name each and every one of you. You know who you are, who have helped us through this period. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, UCSI University is one of the top private universities in Malaysia, offering world-class programs, mainly from performing arts, music, hospitality and leisure, art and design, petroleum and chemical engineering, business, social sciences, and medical, among other critical fields. UCSI is synonymous with graduate outcomes, and the university has a strong track record of collaboration with some of the world's best universities. Through the Star Trek initiatives, UCSI students are annually selected by the universities like Harvard University in the US, Imperial College London, Chicago University, Tsinghua, and Queensland University each year for high impact research. This unique setting sees them working alongside the world's best minds in the pursuit of cutting-edge science. This setting contributes to the strong research culture at UCSI. Our academics are committed in the effort to develop creative human talent and advanced technological innovation, as highlighted by Yang Berhormat YB in your New Year's address recently, which is on Monday, if I'm mistaken. Six UCSI academics are listed in the Stanford's world's top 2% of scientists, and many more have received worldwide recognition for their work. Fourteen fellows of Academy of Sciences Malaysia are also at UCSI University. As we understand, rankings are not the be-all and end-all in higher education, but when coupled with other factors like an ironclad resolve to raise the bar and the commitment to expand the boundaries of knowledge, and it can help us in the effort to attract quality staff and students from around the world. Ladies and gentlemen, UCSI operates based on its core values of audacity, integrity, perseverance, and excellence. Sustainability is also high on the university's agenda, and we go the extra mile to ensure our future generation will inherit a better planet. Next month, we'll be launching the International Institute of Science Diplomacy and Sustainability at UCSI University's Kuala Lumpur campus. And we will continue engaging thought leaders in their respective field to galvanize the university's student and staff communities. UCSI is also investing heavily in Industrial Revolution 4.0 technologies, and over Ringgit Malaysia 28 million was recently invested on the state-of-the-art engineering labs, and more will be done in the future. That is not because I come from the engineering background, Tan Sri. It's just the university's direction. There should be also no gaps between university education and industry relevance. And UCSI will go the extra mile to ensure students are future ready. Delving deeper, UCSI Hospital, located at Bandar Spring Hill, Port Dickson, is a full-fledged quaternary hospital equipped with the state-of-the-art medical technology and teaching facilities. UCSI Hospital looks to step up not only as a great place for healthcare, but also as a teaching hospital that improves outcomes for medical students in Negeri Sembilan and beyond. Ladies and gentlemen, in line with today's launch, I would like to reiterate UCSI's desire to improve life chances with our international branch campus. Currently, UCSI has around 100 Bangladeshi students at the Kuala Lumpur campus. Where are you guys, students? Thank you for joining us. And by establishing a campus in Dhaka, we hope to impact 1,000 more in the near future. Catering to the economic needs of Bangladesh, the branch campus will start by offering 24 degree and master's programs in the field of business, computer science, engineering, architecture, social sciences, and creative design. To conclude, I would like to express my gratitude to Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri Mohamed Khaled Nordin once again, sir, for gracing the soft launch of our first international campus. I would also like to thank all government agencies, partners, associates, and other university management and staff for your goodwill and friendship in making this event a reality. Lastly, I would also like to thank our dedicated partner, Insight Institute of Learning, Bangladesh, for their commitment in making this collaboration a success. Thank you for your great faith, not only in UCSI University, but also in the quality of Malaysia's higher education. We are proud to partner with you, and we look forward to many more milestones in our shared endeavor. Thank you.
Dato. Without further ado, I would like to welcome on stage Pro-Chancellor of UCSI University, Yang Amat Mulia, Tunku Zain Al-Abidin Ibni Tuanku Muhriz, to deliver His Highness speech. Welcome on stage, His Highness.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Very good morning. Suprabhata. Welcome to UCSI University, Yang Berhormat, the Minister of Higher Education, and his senior colleagues from the Ministry of Higher Education, Tan Sri Chairman of the Malaysian Qualifications Agency and CEO, representatives from the People's Republic of Bangladesh, in particular the first Rehana Pravin of the High Commission here, our partner, from the Institute, the Insight Institute of Learning, Bangladesh, and of course my colleagues from UCSI University and the UCSI Group, distinguished guests and academic members of staff. It's a great honor for me to be here with you on this momentous occasion. Today is a proud and impressive moment for UCSI University. The collaboration we have made represents a strong kinship between the People's Republic of Bangladesh and Malaysia. First, I'd like to express my sincere gratitude to the government and the Ministry of Education of both countries for their immense support, trust, and commitment to establishing UCSI's first international campus in Banani, Dhaka, Bangladesh. A country's development is primarily based on its resources and people. Education is the backbone of any country, setting the foundations of institutions and law and how to best make use of resources, human and material. It plays a crucial role in embracing innovation and technological development, which translates to various knowledge, skills, and values. 2 years ago, the COVID-19 pandemic brought about one of the most severe global education disruptions in history. Schools and institutions of higher learning were closed, and the pandemic deepened pre-existing education inequalities that were never adequately addressed. And although it was a challenging moment for us, we always believed in promoting a transformative education that empowers students from all walks of life to be successful individuals in their society and community. And during the pandemic, UCSI took bold actions to provide learning continuity. And in fact, when I was newly appointed as pro-chancellor, I did have the opportunity to come to the campus, and despite the pandemic, I saw some of the amazing work that the faculties were doing to maintain online learning. We even organized a concert during COVID for the victims of the floods in nearby Cheras. I visited the hospital in Bandar Spring Hill near Port Dickson, and I saw how UCSI was involved in the vaccination programs during COVID. So I'm really proud of what UCSI managed to achieve during that very difficult period. And but of course, UCSI has long been one of Malaysia's first private universities. We have long impacted the national higher education landscape here. And with that track record, we've expanded access through online learning platforms, provided mental health support now for students, which is tremendously important since COVID, and also simplified the university admissions process. Thanks to the Learning Management System, LMS, course networking digital platform that was implemented during the pandemic, now UCSI is the first private university in Malaysia to have adopted this, and we're the biggest course networking adopter in the country by student numbers. And with this digital platform in place, the 2019-2020 students could complete their studies and graduate concurrently in 2021. And I know that our founder and executive chairman of UCSI Group, Dr. Peter Ng, has strongly believes in the potential and openness of young people. He has long aspired to make education a force to unite people and nationalities, as well as creating a knowledge-based society and sustainable future. As Dato Vice Chancellor mentioned earlier, the Star Trek program is an excellent initiative by the university, providing students the opportunity to travel and learn from the best universities worldwide, instilling values of diversity and inclusiveness as well. We are, of course, firmly committed to supporting the education goal of the United Nations Sustainable Development Goal 4, quality education, which aims to ensure inclusive and equitable quality education and promote lifelong learning opportunities for all. In addition, we also uphold Sustainable Development Goal 17, Partnership for the Goals, ensuring to strengthen the means of implementation and revitalize the global partnership for sustainable development. To achieve this, UCSI will continue strengthening our national and international partnerships, supporting all our stakeholders and partners. And I'm so happy that the Minister has found the time this morning to be here with us and to show the Malaysian government's commitment to those international partnerships as the whole world comes out of COVID and seeks to elevate the delivery of higher education worldwide. Distinguished guests, I've been informed that Bangladesh has a GDP of $461 billion, population of 170 million residents, the strong record of growth and development. Even in times of elevated global uncertainty, education is in high demand amongst Bangladesh's 17 million students, or about 10% of the population. I trust our partnership with the People's Republic of Bangladesh and Insight Institute of Learning will enable both parties to develop youth with a global perspective who are willing to progress in various fields. Let us move forward together so that everyone can have better access to high quality education, thrive, and dream of being what they want through the gaining of knowledge. Let's make sure our future generations can access the education they need to create a more sustainable, inclusive, and prosperous world for all. I'd like to congratulate UCSI on this magnificent new campus. I think just now we saw the model, the digital model. It looks fantastic. So I'm looking forward, inshallah, one day to go and visit. This is the first international branch to sprout from the UCSI family tree. So I'm very happy, we are here in Cheras. We have a presence in Negeri Sembilan, of course, and in Dhaka. So I trust that this new campus will bring the best possible education for the young people of Bangladesh and well beyond that. Again, gratitude goes to the Honorable Minister of Higher Education, Dato Sri Mohamed Khaled bin Nordin, for gracing this occasion. Thank you to the officials and the MQA and other agencies for making all of this happen. I know that when you have different regulations and different standards across countries, it can take a lot of work to get through that. So thank you very much. I wish you all every success, and I thank you. Dan ya badaba. Thank you.
Thank you, His Highness. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, we have reached to the pinnacle of today's event. Now, I would like to welcome the Minister of Higher Education, Yang Berhormat, Dato Sri Mohamed Khaled bin Nordin, to deliver his speech and officiate the soft launch of UCSI University Bangladesh campus. Let's give Yang Berhormat Dato Sri a warm welcome on stage.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera and a very good morning to all. Yang Amat Mulia Tengku Zain Al-Abidin Ibni Tuanku Mukhris, Pro Chancellor UCSI University. Yang Bahagia Dato' Dr. Husaini, Ketua Pengarah Jabatan Pengajian Tinggi. Yang Bahagia Tan Sri Hairul Adib, Pengerusi MQA. Dato' Muhammad Shatta, CEO MQA. Yang Berbahagia Dato' Peter Ng, UCSI Group Founder and Executive Chairman. Yang Berbahagia Profesor Dato' Dr. Siti Hamisah, Vice Chancellor. Ms. Rehana Parvin from the Bangladesh High Commission. Mr. Ariful Bari Majunda from Insight Institute of Learning Bangladesh, pegawai daripada kementerian dan jabatan, pengurusan tertinggi universiti, dev-dev jemputan, tuan-tuan dan puan-puan hadirin hadirat yang saya hormati sekalian. Pertamanya saya ucapkan berbanyak terima kasih kerana diberi peluang dan kesempatan untuk hadir ke UCSI University. Sempena dengan pelancaran kampus Bangladesh-nya pada pagi yang berbahagia ini. I would like to thank the university for giving me the honor on this occasion today. This is the second time I've been here to this university. The last time was about 10 years ago, or more or less. About 10 years ago. And I've seen so many development and improvement, not only the buildings, but I'm told that there are now more students and lecturers. So I would like to congratulate the university for all this development. Of course, as mentioned by the Pro-Chancellor and the Vice-Chancellor, as a new minister, surely I am very busy. But I took time to come to your university. The very fact that I accept your invitation is actually a strong endorsement of the ministry to your university. More so, when I see that those who have served me before is now serving your university. So, surely I cannot go wrong, and the university will not go wrong. I made to understand that it has been 37 years for the university. So today is another milestone. I therefore would like to congratulate UCSI for this soft launch of your university in Bangladesh. I believe it is a giant leap in the university's history. It is a remarkable milestone, and to the Ministry of Higher Education Malaysia, it is exemplary for several reasons. Firstly, as far as we are concerned, there is a significant move towards greater internationalization of higher education. We actually live in a world where global issues know no borders. Thus, the need for cross-cultural collaboration and knowledge sharing has never been greater. Geographical barriers should never limit the potential of working together to develop new knowledge and fresh ideas. Our goal of internationalization at the ministry is not just about attracting international students as a higher education and talent hub. It also entails promoting cultural exchange, creating new partnerships, and developing global citizens. To do that, we must expand our horizon and look beyond. We must be present in other jurisdictions. Our system, our programs, our academics, they must be offered to talents beyond Malaysia's border. What better way to manifest this than to encourage our higher education institution to set up international branch campuses? This move, among others, will propel Malaysia towards becoming a regional and global player recognized for our academic and research excellence. Secondly, this transnational initiative is a hallmark of knowledge diplomacy. Knowledge diplomacy is a crucial tool to build bridges, to exchange ideas, to foster mutual understanding between nations and communities. From our previous approach, as an importer of ideas, structures, and models of higher education, we need a new paradigm. We must be proactive. We must reach out to others. That is why the ministry strongly supports the push for established private higher education providers to set up more overseas branch campuses. Thirdly, this milestone increases access and equity for human capital development. The establishment of this branch campus will surely provide many more educational and research opportunities for local Bangladeshi and students across the region. It increases access to high quality education that can help them reach their full potential and achieve their goals without having to leave their own country. In many ways, this is about sowing a seed for a more educated, skilled, talented, and diverse workforce that can contribute to the growth and prosperity of communities. This is certainly an investment in the future, not just the future of Bangladesh, but the future of the region and the world. Fourthly, this milestone is remarkable as a leading model for other private higher education institutions across Malaysia. It is my desire to stir up fervor within private higher education institutions to broaden their horizon, to open branch campuses both domestically and abroad, either independently or through a consortium or partnership of like-minded institutions. I believe that private higher education institutions can seize the advantage they have to venture into uncharted territories. Advantages such as greater adaptability, visionary leadership, astute management, and agile financial system, among others. There is no doubt that challenges exist, but with every challenge comes the opportunity to progress and innovate beyond the conventional. For all these reasons, I applaud UCSI for trailblazing this path for other private higher education institutions. Ladies and gentlemen, I take the invite from UCSI for the ministry and I to be here today as a reflection of confidence of this institution that it will deliver quality education program, that it will succeed in nurturing good talents. I cannot reinforce it better than to reiterate our commitment at the ministry to striving towards building a healthy relationship and ecosystem for the growth and expansion of private higher education institutions. As I outlined in my New Year's message early this week, this is a concerted effort from each and every agency in the higher education sector. I will continue spearheading efforts to enhance communication between the accreditation agencies and private higher education institutions. The internationalization of MQA cannot occur in isolation from the role of private higher education institutions in their internationalization endeavor. We need more contemporary accreditation standards, greater room for private institutions to revise their curriculum, to explore new models, new pedagogy, and new learning experiences without being too restricted by regulation. We promise to phase out certain archaic practices of educational policing, which might unhealthily inhibit growth. But this does not imply that the higher education sector should be devoid of regulation. Instead, we must nurture a culture of self-regulation that is transparent and holistic. During my tenure, hopefully this government lasts for 5 years. So you will see me for the next 5 years. During my tenure, I will seek to explore how we can provide incentive to successful higher education institutions. Example of this include introducing matching grants for doctoral degree training, providing access to various data in the spirit of knowledge sharing, increasing joint research funding, and various other innovative incentives. I certainly welcome recommendation that will propel our higher education sector to the next level. I believe that this is a team effort, and this is the very reason why I make no difference between public and private higher education institutions. For me, both are part of Malaysian universities. And I'm also the minister for the private higher education institution. For UCSI, you are a Malaysian brand. Your success is our success. So once again, congratulations to UCSI, to Dato' Peter, to Dato' Dr. Siti Hamisah, to Yang Amat Mulia Tunku on this latest milestone. I would like also to congratulate Insight Institute of Learning, the UCSI local partners in Bangladesh. Thank you for the faith you have given to UCSI and the Malaysian brand of higher education. The joint commitment of both parties today is by any measure a very bold move. All of us at the ministry wish you the very best as you embark on this shared endeavor. On that note, I would like to once again wish you all good luck and thank you for the invitation.
Thank you, Yang Berhormat Datuk Sri. Please remain on stage as we proceed to the main highlight of the event. Now, I would like to request Mr. Chan Jo Jim, Pro Vice Chancellor Designate UCSI University Bangladesh Campus, to accompany the following dignitaries to join Yang Berhormat Datuk Sri on stage for the soft launch of UCSI University Bangladesh Campus. Yang Amat Mulia Tuanku Zain Al-Abidin Ibni Tuanku Muhriz, Pro Chancellor of UCSI University. Yang Berbahagia Datuk Peter Ng, Executive Chairman and Founder of UCSI Group. Yang Berbahagia Profesor Dato' Insinyur Teknologis Dr. Siti Hamisah binti Tapsi, Chancellor of UCSI University and Chief Executive Officer of UCSI Group. Ms. Rehana Parvin, First Secretary of Foreign Affairs, Bangladesh High Commission. Mr. Arifu Bari Majunda, Managing Director of Insight Institute of Learning Bangladesh. Now, I would like to invite our guest of honor, Yang Berhormat Datuk Sri Mohamed Khaled bin Nordin, the Minister of Higher Education, to officiate the soft launch of the UCSI University Bangladesh campus by signing on the poster frame. Thank you, Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri. Please remain on stage as we have a token of appreciation presentation from UCSI University and Insight Institute of Learning. Now, I would like to invite Yang Amat Mulia Tuanku Zain Al-Abidin Ibni Tuanku Muhriz, Pro-Chancellor of UCSI University, to present a token of appreciation on behalf of UCSI University to Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri. Thank you, His Highness. Now, I would like to invite Mr. Ariful Bari Majunda, Managing Director of Insight Institute of Learning Bangladesh, to present a token of appreciation to Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri. Thank you, Mr. Ariful Bari. For the group photography session, I would like to invite on stage Yang Berbahagia Professor Datuk Dr. Husaini bin Omar, Director General of the Department of Higher Education, the Ministry of Higher Education of Malaysia, Yang Berbahagia Tan Sri Muhammad Khairul Adib Abdul Rahman, Chairman Malaysian Qualifications Agency Council, Yang Berbahagia Professor Datuk Dr. Muhammad Shatar bin Sabran, Chief Executive Officer Malaysian Qualification Agency, University Council members and representative from the Insight Institute of Learning Bangladesh. Once again, thank you, Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri Muhammad Khaled bin Nordin. Ladies and gentlemen, I would now like to invite Yang Berhormat Datuk Seri and all stage parties to return to their seats.